Here we are in a first match on the play. This hand seems rather full of lands, but this is exactly what the deck is doing. So in this hand we got Prismatic Omen, so we're gonna fetch a basic forest, Suspend Search for Tomorrow, and since we got Velakit and some fetches, we can start flinging three damages around like quite soon by turn six or five with Search for Tomorrow. So we're gonna keep this. If we draw any sort of acceleration, this hand's gonna be great. There's a lot of cards we can draw with this hand to make it really good. So, and even by itself, it's not the worst. Well, it's unfortunate our opponent mulls to four. Hopefully, we still have a game. I'm gonna crack Misty, and I'm cracking Misty, because I don't expect to fetch a basic island in this game. If something, I'm gonna fetch Steam Vents. Actually, that is not true. I should probably use Witted Fiddles. Well, no, never mind. I have Scalding Tarn. That's fine. Let's suspend this. Hopefully, we don't get Spell Snared here. I think I'm gonna play Stumping Ground, because if I do get I'm gonna play Wooded Foothills. Yeah, I'm gonna play Wooded Foothills and fetch basic mountain. Because if I do get countered my Prismatic Omen, then I really wanna have actual mountains in play so that Valakut is triggered as fast as possible. I would have gotten Stomping Ground on one, usually. But since I had Prismatic Omen, I don't want to take that much. I don't want to take too much damage from my lands, because it's likely not going to matter if Prismatic Omen stays around. Fetches Owl Fountain. It's got Seagram Kosum too. Wall of Omens. Okay, so we're playing against blue-white control. It's having a not too bad multi four. Not stumbling so far. We'll get Island just to. We could get Island just to. I guess. We could bluff counter spells. But I think it's probably better if we hide it. And then we get him later with Swan Songs. So again, I'm still going to get. I'm still going to fetch basic mountains, because he has Cryptic Command in his deck, most likely, so he has ways to deal with Prismatic Omen. We're gonna play Colony Heart Expedition with Valakut. Put counters on it. Next turn we can play a fetch, which will put two counters on Colony Heart Expedition, and the next two. Now we can crack the Calling Yard and deal six as we want, which we'll probably save for Restoration Angel or something like that, until we draw Titan or Scapeshift. He V-clicks us, which won't do anything, funnily. Sure, go ahead. I think for Restoration Angel purposes, I will. Yes. I will shoot the click main phase. Yeah, sacrifice this. Get Stomping Ground. Tapped. Put two counters here. Suck this thing. We'll get mountain forest, I guess. Get two triggers. And pass turn. Played Flooded Strand and is passing. He's having pretty good multi four. Okay, so I think we want to just cycle this. Or we could also wait, because all of our land drops is 3 damage to the face. So yeah, I like just slinging lands and waiting. We're not really in a rush. And I would be disappointed if I discarded 2 lands and he countered like the spells I played. So we're not gonna be hasty here. Although drawing another Valakut would be insane. Sakura is as good as a land here, so still gonna play it, because if I'm scared of playing it, it's kind of a land that can be countered, but the thing that counters it is Spell Snare, which counters is a charm. So if you spend Spell Snare on this, I'm kinda happy, I guess. Play my land. Also, I guess I don't want to show him that I'm playing blue yet. There's not much value in that, because if I do get a blue source game 2, he's probably gonna catch that I'm playing counter spells anyway. So he pathes Wall of Omens. Because Path doesn't do much in the matchup. He gets my Titan, I guess. But yes, he wants to cast Sun Titan, which is going to get back V-Click. And we'll see who he targets. Targets Sun Titan on click. I guess I'm kind of lucky he hasn't drawn a Tectonic Edge or Ghost Quarter, because this is 2 cards that this card usually plays. Target me. I'm not gonna kill it because there's absolutely no reason at this point. But I will crack this Sakura in response so that I don't draw. I minimize the chance of drawing a basic, because it's not exactly what I want. I want fetches or Valakut. So blue, red, draw 2. And found Lightning Bolt, which, well, I guess I had to discard 2 cards anyway, so I'm gonna keep Lightning Bolt so I can cast it end of turn. Well, or just, yeah, in response to click, I mean. Discard 2. Bolt you. I could have kept land, but the thing is, if I draw another land, I can't kill him. Now, any draw. Basically, I think almost any of our draws just kill him. Any of our draws but Expedition, Pyroclasm, and Omen. And I guess Izzet Charm as well. One of our Izzet Charms. Well, that's unfortunate. I guess we keep it in hand. I would be really unfortunate if we lose that game. He multi 4 and didn't do much, and we kind of had, like, I wouldn't say the nuts, because we didn't draw Scapeshift for a Titan, but. And now we could likely lose this game. Because he's now off any. We can't draw just a land. If we draw Valakut, it works. And if we draw a fetch, it works. If we draw. No blockers. If we draw a Titan or Scapeshift, it works, but he's likely having a counterspell. Let's see, he hasn't played any. Come on, we can do this. We gotta fetch. Guess I'm playing. Guess I'm playing Prismatic Omen first. Is there a downside? Cryptic. Yeah, sure. I think there's no downside. I'm playing it first. I think it's a safety more than anything. Yield three to you. So he could have Cryptic. He could have Cryptic if he. Well, I could crack my fetch, and then he cryptics, bounce the Valakut, goes to one. So I don't really have any ways around it. So I'm just gonna do it. I could wait on his upkeep in case he cracks lat end of turn, but it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen if he's any good. All right, we did it, boys. By drawing almost just lands. It's all we did, just land drops. So this is one of the attraction of playing Prismatic Omen, is that it's pretty great with Valakut, especially when you have to. He's cracking your response. What does he have? Oh, he could Resto and then gain two extra life. No! It doesn't do anything. That's fine. It still dies. Alright. After board, I believe we probably want Rending Volleys instead of Pyroclasms. Seems like a strict upgrade. Relic, probably reasonable. I don't know if they play Snapcasters, but Sun Titan, Returning, Ghost Squadron, on and on, it seems annoying. It's probably better than at least one Lightning Bolt. I even doubt Rending Volley is that good. Like, it's not like I care about his creatures. Is a charm. It's probably reasonable. Swan Song. I think on the play, I'd probably rather have be more proactive and have Swan Songs to back up my stuff than have Raining Volleys to stop him. On the draw, I'll reconsider. But I think on the play, something like that. Even as a charm, the 2 damage mode isn't very useful. I think it might be better to have Swan Song. It sure cycles, but as we saw, I kind of want to hit all my land drops. So there's not much I want to discard with it. So we're going to try four Swan Songs. It's probably too much. It still gives them a 2-2, which beats us down. Yeah, we'll try that way. Okay, so he's on the play. He kept 7, and this hand's good. Yeah, two counterspells, Valakut already, and got 2 Colony Arts. So this is a case where I'm probably not going to crack my fetch until I have 2 Expeditions in play. Valakut on 1. Probably going to play Forest on 2, Colony Heart. Following turn, Colony Heart again, play our fetch. Probably gonna get countered. Yep, spell snared it. Second island. Gonna play another one. I could want to place Mr. in Forest so we back it with a counterspell. But I wouldn't be excited to Swan Song counterspell here. Probably want to keep it for Scapeshift. And also it's a land drop we lose if the Colony Art actually ends up resolving. So at this point, we're pretty well set up. We could potentially have two counter spells to back up our Scapeshift later. So great so far. Oh, that's an annoying card. So that's a reason I want is a charm, I believe. I'm gonna crack in response, so I get my blue source, and I can is a charm later. Get a mountain, put a counter on that thing. I'll go say I'm gonna consider. I'm definitely gonna keep the second is a charm for game three if we have one, and I will consider keeping Lightning Bolt as well. Actually, Raining Folly instead. No, Detention Sphere on a Kali art. That's it's definitely annoying because this hand needs seven lands to work, and we just lost two. But, well, we'll take the opportunity that he's tapped out to kill it. We'll play this fetch. And probably keep it around in case we draw a Prismatic Omen or a Kalni Heart. Whoa, this card's gonna be hard to beat. Search. We probably want to get as much mountain as possible so we can start dealing damage with Valakut and eventually get rid of that Glenalandra. Play a Secret Toes tap so it can't attack with Colonnade yet. And attacking. Okay, so now we got enough lands for Valakut. Sure. That can resolve. I would probably expect him to let us keep both of these cards, but maybe take Scapeshift because we can eventually kill the Glenalandra Archmage. Yeah, he took Scapeshift. We drew Explorer, which is pretty good here. We can start Valakuting. I'm gonna start my turn with Explore. Decides to counter it, which is I think probably a wise choice. So we got access to four, five mountains. So I'm gonna play a basic mountain. Pass. So on my turn, I'm gonna crack Wooded Foothills, play Misty, and get Stomping Ground. Shoot Glen or Vanillin Click, depending on what my draw is. If I'm looking to resolve something, probably better kill Glen. He didn't attack with Colonnade here. That would maybe explain he has a counterspell in hand. So, I can play Valakut so that I have two triggers next turn. I can kill both of his creatures. But the thing is, if he attacks me with four next turn, I'm down to seven, and attacks with Colonnade, let's say. He would deal. Would be down to three and then die to Colonnade. So if I kill this on this turn, I kill V-Click. I need to fetch twice, which puts me down to nine. I kill Click. He can attack with Glen and Colonnade. I go down to four, and it's the same clock. So the play is probably to play Valakut tapped, and then next turn reevaluate and hope he doesn't attack with Colonnade because no matter what, it's not going to change the clock. And there's a good chance he doesn't attack with Colonnade if he didn't that turn. So I think I'll do that. But we need to draw something really good on my turn. Like, I probably need to draw a business spell such as Titan or Scapeshift on my turn if I want to be able to win this game. Doesn't attack with colonnade, so plan worked out. Still not gonna crack my fetch because if I draw Colony Heart, I wanna have it around. I wanna have the fetch around. And same thing for Prismatic Omen. Ew, that's pretty bad draw. I did misplay really bad earlier. When I played Explorer and he countered it with Glenn, I think I should have Swansonged my own Explorer so that I have a 2-2 that not only blocks Archmage but could have traded with Vendilion Click. So that's definitely a huge mistake, I think. I definitely think it's a really bad mistake because I drew the second Swansong and it could be biased because of that. And I want to keep this. If I didn't draw a second one, I would be happy to have one in my hand. But I think it's better to have the 2-2 at that moment anyway. So either way, I'm going to play this fetch and kill both of his creatures on his turn. I should have probably done it upkeep because, well, one of the reasons is Ghost Squatter, which he just played, and the second reason is if you resto the Gland and Lander Archmage, it's kind of bad. Oh wow, he tapped the Ghost Squatter, so we actually have a chance now. So now another mistake. I should have shoot stuff before attacking so that if he has to make mana with Colonnade, it's tapped and can't attack with it. So another mistake. So I have to get Stomping Ground. And we get basic mountain. Deal 3 to this and 3 to this. We go to 1. And we're down to 1. Come on. Escape shift. Oh, how lucky. Hopefully it doesn't have two counters, but I can't think of any two counter spells that would deal with Scapeshift, so. We'll flow to blue in case he has something after Scapeshift. We have blue floating. He has negate, we swan song. And now let's not blow it up. So sac forest, we need to deal 20. So I have two Valakuts out. I can sac all of my lands. Just gonna make sure how many left I have. I have 4, 5, 6. I have 3 stomping grounds left and 3 mountains. So I'm gonna get these 6 plus a Valakut. So 3. 1, 2, just making sure what this is. Okay. 4, I have 7 mountain in my deck, so I have 3 left, and 3 stomping grounds, sacrifice. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Making sure everything is selected. It's really hard to see if everything is actually selected. Okay, this is, I think this is it? It is now. It's really hard to see. And Valakut is, and we got infinite triggers, and he dies. And he's dead. So, see you for match two.